Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make guides in Adobe Illustrator from any shape, line, or even text. And by guides, I mean those little lines that you can pull from the rulers, from the vertical or horizontal rulers. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the simple way to do this is to just select your object, then come up here to View, Guides, and Make Guides like this. And now you can see it's turned it into a guide. I'm gonna undo. You can also select your object and just hit Command 5 or Control 5. That's the keyboard shortcut for that. But you might notice that you're not getting the result you want. And if that's the case, you're probably either trying text or a more complex shape like this. So if you have more complex shapes, maybe you want the stroke to be part of the guide too. You want your text to be guides. Your first step is to either expand or create outlines if it's text. So I'm going to select my text. We'll just do that one first and go to Type, Create Outlines, and then I'm going to hit Command 5 or Control 5 to create guides like this. And this might be helpful if you want to leave instructions in a template file, something like that, where it's not an existing shape that somebody can easily delete. Now these other two shapes, this one is a rectangle that has a warp applied to it. So if I was to take this rectangle, go up to Effect, Warp, and then Arc, this will give us the same result. I'm gonna undo that. But if we hit Command Y or Control Y, we can see that this is still just a rectangle. And this, with the strokes on it, is just a single circle. I'm gonna hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. So we need to expand this. If we hit Command 5 or Control 5 right now, we just get the rectangle. If we come up here to Object, we'll either want Expand or Expand Appearance, whichever is available. I'm going to choose Expand Appearance in this case. And it expands it out to its full shape, and then I can hit Command 5 or Control 5. And it'll be the same process with this green circle with a purple stroke. We'll come up here to Object. We've got Expand available. I'll do that. And now everything is expanded out all the way to its edges. And if we hit Command 5 or Control 5, that gives us the result we want. Now that stroke is halfway over the edge of the original circle and halfway outside it. Half on the interior of the original circle and half outside it. And that's why you're seeing three lines. This part is the original circle and this is the edge of that stroke. I'm gonna undo. If you only wanted the purple to be a shape and then the green, we could take our Shape Builder tool with Shift M, that'll bring us to this tool right over here, and just combine those pieces into one. Then if we hit Command 5 or Control 5, we just have where the stroke was and where the fill was here. So if Command 5 or Control 5 isn't working the way you want it, just make sure you've created outlines or expanded and expand appearance. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.